Hi everyone. Today we are here actually to answer some questions about the DV lottery, actually green card applications. In a couple of days, State Department is going to announce when they're going to start actually receiving the applications for DV programs, which is usually starts beginning of October and goes until beginning of November. This is why we're answering some of the questions we receive from our followers to clarify this DV lottery process or questions or issues. The first question we receive from our followers says, what is the diversity visa program? So they want to know what this program is about. Diversity immigrant visa program is one type of way the people actually for foreign people to be able to apply or receive the green card to be able to stay in the US and live and work. And usually for the diversity program, doing this way, the US government allows actually foreign people. And usually it looks at the countries in a way that if the nationals of the one country has been immigrating to US in the last 5 years, if those people have been less than 50,000 people actually getting the green card, it allows actually US to be able to bring more diverse people to live in the US and be part of the community here. And the calculation, the way they look is usually to see that if that country has been allowing less people to immigrate to the US, so they want to make sure that they bring those cultures or those people also to be able to live in the US. Another question we receive says about how to submit to entry. Once, you know, we can say that there is of course limited period of time where people can register for the diversity immigrant visa program for every year. You know, Department of State publishes details about this on their website, and it allows people, the applicants, to apply through the electronic diversity visa website, which is dvlottery.state.gov, to be able to register and file for their green card applications. What I could say that the people will be able to submit their applications beginning of October, and it's going to last until the beginning of November. And pretty sure we're going to get the dates where people will be able to start filing and the last day that they're going to be able to file for the DV lottery for 2020. Another question we receive is about the selection of applicants that who apply for this DV lottery program. Each year, Department of State conducts a random selection of diversity immigrant visas applicants and based on allocations of visas available to each region and country from all those registered entries. So we could say here is the selection happens actually through the computerized system, and usually if the people will be able to file for the applications next month, which is October of 2018, then the May of 2019, people will be able to know that the applicants will be able to know that if they're being selected or not. So another question we receive from our followers says, so what happens if I'm selected from this DV lottery application? So if you're selected, that means following year by May, once you check the State Department website with your confirmation number for your case, for your application, you're going to be able to find out if you're selected or not. And if you're selected, that means then you're going to be able to proceed with your green card application by contacting and filing your DS form with the Kentucky Service Center and waiting for your case number to become available. And once your visa number becomes available, then you're going to be able to actually go to U.S. consulate in your country and get your immigrant visa to be able to come to the United States. So what are the qualifications do I need once I'm selected to actually get the green card? The Diversity Immigrant Visa, which is DV program, requires the principal DV applicant to have a high school education or its equivalent, or 2 years of qualifying work experience as defined under provisions of U.S. law. And if you do not have either the required education or qualifying work experience, then you're not qualified to be issued diversity visa. So you either have to have a high school education, which is a high school education means successful completion of a formal course of elementary and secondary education comparable to the completion of a 12-year course in the United States. And work experience, if you're qualifying with work experience, you must have the 2 years of experience in the last 5 years in an occupation, which by U.S. Department of Labor defines definitions, requires at least 2 years of training or experience that is designated as a job zone 4 or 5 classified in the specific vocational preparation rating of 7 or higher. Basically, SVB rating has to be 7 or higher. So once you select it, then you have to submit your immigrant visa and alien registration application. So this application actually calls DS-260, which is DS-260. That means if the person is selected of this application, then he and the family member has to file DS-260, and you need to be able to include your family members as well. And if there's any changes, then you may have to actually, mention that in this application to be able to be, qualified to receive the immigrant visa. So what happens once you select it and you file the DS-260? So then you're going to have to actually put together your supporting documents to qualify actually for your immigrant visa. And secondly, you have to check to see if the visa numbers become available for you to receive an appointment to get an appointment date at the U.S. consulate. And once you have the appointment date for the consulate and you get all the documents that you will need to take with you, then you're going to be able to actually go to appointment and to be able to and receive your immigrant visa. How someone can be prepared for the interview actually for the DV applicant? You should definitely prepare yourself for the interview, in detail and carefully. Failure to be fully prepared for your interview at the U.S. Embassy or consulate can result in delay or denial of your visa application. After you have been notified of your scheduled interview, you will need to take the following important steps in order to make sure that, you're ready for the appointment. First of all, you have to carefully review your scheduled information in the entrance status check on the e-visa DV lottery website. Make sure that where, what time, and then where the location is. Second, review U.S. Embassy or consulate interview instructions, because there might be some additional things you will have to do before you go to appointment. Thirdly, you have to schedule and complete a medical examination. You and each family member applying for visa with you are required to schedule a medical appointment with an authorized physician in your country where you will actually have the appointment. So you have to complete all those medicals and take the report with you to actually your appointment. Four, you have to gather photographs and all remaining required documents with you for the appointment. The photo has to be taken within the last 6 months and has to comply with the passport style picture requirements. So then when you go to appointment, you take with you applicant information printed from the website, and then you have to take the confirmation page for DS-260 filing, and you have to take your passport and other original documents or certified copies with you. So this way you pay your fees for your diversity visa process fee, and then you appear at the consulate. So what happens after the interview at the U.S. consulate or embassy? At the end of your immigrant visa interview at the U.S. consulate or embassy, the consular officer will inform you whether your application is approved or denied. If it's approved, then you will be informed how and when your passport and visa will be returned to you. But if it's denied, then you'll be informed why you're ineligible to receive a visa. There's additional information about the visa denials at the State Department website or the consulate website, the way you will be able to find out about it. So once you approve, once you get your visa, then how you're going to be able to come to the United States or enter the United States to receive your green card. So when traveling to the United States, the primary applicant must enter before or at the same time as family members with the visas. With your diversity visa, before it expires, your sealed package, you will travel to the United States port of entry and request permission to enter the United States. A visa does not guarantee entry into the United States. If you're admitted, you will enter as a lawful permanent resident, also called a green card holder, and will be permitted to work and live permanently in the United States.